Yo, what up? It's D-Face, DXA. It's been a minute since I made like a beat making video or something related to samplers. So, you know, people still ask me a lot of questions and people still ask me a lot of the same questions. Also, I got the SP1200 form, so I have a lot of questions coming in there. And I thought instead of typing the same answer out to the question, you know, maybe I'll make a video and just give everyone a reply in one place. So if you got any questions or something I find interesting, let me know. Maybe I'll make a video about it if I got some good feedback on the subject. So a question I get a good amount of time is, how do you take a stereo record and put it into a mono sampler? Because the stereo is left and right and the mono sampler is one input. So there's two basic ways to go about this. I'm gonna go over both of them, and also I'm gonna go over a third way, which is a little bit more intricate and it might not make sense to everybody, but you know, while I'm on the subject, I might as well cover all the angles. So the first way would be, you take the stereo record, you listen to both sides, the left and the right, and you pick which side you wanna use. And then you sample that into your mono sampler. You could use your patch bay, you could use the back of the turntable, you could use your DJ mixer, your phono preamp, whatever, and you just run either the left or right into your sampler and sample your sample source. Pretty basic. That's what I do, because for the most part, if I'm sampling something, there's gonna be one side of the record that I like better, and that goes even if I'm using a stereo sampler. If I have to use a stereo sample, it's for a particular reason, because I want both sides. So for the most part, either the signal's louder, there's an instrument, there's something going on in one side that I like better than the other, and that's what I sample into the sampler. And that's the most basic way, and that's what I do for majority of the time. The next way, and I know some people do this, is you can use a Y cable, and you can take both the left and the right, put them on top of each other, and sample that into your mono sampler. You could use same thing, you know, use your patch bay, but instead of running one wire, you run the Y cable and then run the one end of the Y cable into your mono input. And this would take the left and the right and put them on top of each other, so you're not losing anything. And for me, like, there's not really a time where I would do that, but some people, they feel like maybe they're missing something or they don't want to take the time to pick which side they want off the record. And I guess one issue with that would be, technically, when you take the left and right and put it on top of each other, they're phasing, so the sounds are going to cancel each other out, they're going to phase out. But most records are set up so that you could put the left on top of the right without a problem. But technically, if it's the exact same thing on the left and the right, those sounds are going to cancel each other out by phasing each other out, because you're putting on top of each other. So those are like the two basic ways that you will go about taking a stereo sample and putting it into a mono sampler. There is another more like advanced way, and it requires more time and more legwork and might not be suitable for every situation and doesn't really make sense with something like the 1200, where you don't have a lot of sampling time. But what you could do is you could take the left, sample it, take the right and sample it separately and put them on top of each other. Now you could have two samplers or two 950s, a 950 and a 900, and run the sources and hit trigger them at the same time, or set it up with a audio trigger where they both start recording at the same time, and then take the disc out of one sampler and put it in the other and line them up perfectly. Or maybe you do something with a DAW where you have where you set up the audio trigger and you could just chop it perfectly and record it that way using just one sampler. And then when you line everything up perfectly in the sampler, you assign them to two different outputs, then you pan them on your board, you pan them in your DAW or whatever. But you know, that's a lot of legwork, but it's technically another way that you could use a stereo sound and put it into a mono sampler, and you could also keep the stereo qualities of what you're trying to sample. Now, I don't know, some people it's like, that's too much work, or if I'm using a mono sampler, why would I do all that? But again, like I said, you know, sometimes the fun is figuring out how you want to do what was in your head, exactly, even if it doesn't work with the machine. If it was meant to only sample mono, that doesn't mean you only have to sample mono. So I just wanted to go over that aspect of it. Like I said, if you got two 950s, it's a little bit easier. You just take the disc and then, you know, trigger them, make sure you truncate everything perfectly, and you wouldn't necessarily need a stereo sampler to accomplish stereo sampling. So got any follow-up questions, or like I said in the beginning, if you got any other topics or issues for me to go over, let me know. Maybe I'll make a video about it. But I'm out. This motherfucker, D-Face, DXA Records. DXA all day. What's up?